Hi, Oregon. Can you hear me? Hello. Oregon. Can you hear me? Hi, Rahul.
Deepak,
Sir, welcome. I'll just start with the Olympic tribute cartoons. Let's see how many will join. I mean, this is a very short notice interaction. So not many people are joining, but if you have any questions, you can send the questions even on YouTube. I will try my best to interact with everybody. Hi Abhinav and hi Vijay Kumar. Thanks for joining.
Are you drawing it live now?
Ravindra on YouTube. Thanks for joining. So if you have any question, you can type it on YouTube also. I'll try to respond to each one. Hi, Vinay Mathur. Thanks for joining. Hi Dattatri and hi Naisha Kurana. Thanks for joining. Thanks for the compliments. Hi, Vaibhav. There's a question from Ravi Suman. He's asking me, are you using Adobe Illustrator? I used to draw cartoons with Adobe Photoshop. Then I switched on to Krita. I thought it was more suitable. I'm trying to work on Adobe Photoshop again. I haven't tried Illustrator yet. This interaction was arranged at the last minute. I just wanted to share these Olympic tribute cartoons on the Independence Day. That is the only reason. It was done at a very short notice. Really sorry to the subscribers who got the message very late. Dattatri is asking, is Krita similar to Photoshop or different? It's almost similar to Photoshop. I found Krita better for coloring. You can draw better in Photoshop because you have a better control, but in Krita, you can color in a better way. There are many more options. It's more like doing a painting, creating a painting. Thanks, Dattatri. Thanks, Deepak sir. Really sorry that this interaction was arranged at the last minute. I just wanted to share these cartoons on Independence Day. That's it. Not many subscribers are online. Feel free to ask questions. There's a question from Zenith. Do you draw in Photoshop using mouse? No, I don't use mouse now. I use a Wacom tablet. It's a Wacom Cintiq. It's more like drawing on a computer. It's convenient and it saves lots of time also. Drawing with mouse is very tedious. Thanks, Neil Murthy, for your kind words. Any more questions? Okay, Rahul is asking, please put your captions in Hindi as well. I'd love to do, I mean, translate my cartoons into Hindi and post on social media, because there's a bigger audience for Hindi cartoons. But unfortunately, my written Hindi is not that good. Maybe I need to hire somebody to translate my cartoons into Hindi and then post it on social media. I surely try to do that.
Thanks for that.
Okay, Ravi Suman is asking, I recently started cartooning. I always stuck in detailing. My boss always complains that my cartoons look like real images. Maybe you should try to draw freely without any restrictions. Maybe because you have been drawing the realistic figures or portraits, that you are stuck with the realistic drawing style. Maybe you can just loosen up and draw wildly. Just exaggerate. Just have fun. Okay, Vaibhav is asking how to concept a cartoon, political issue, or to do some fun connect to the issue. I didn't get the question completely. So are you asking about how to come up with political cartoons? Vaibhav? There's a question from Neil Murthy. What do you think is a good platform for amateur cartoons in India? What was your journey like? I have shared my journey many times, so I don't want to go back to the repeating the same thing. About the platform, I think social media is a good platform. You may not be able to earn anything or monetize your cartoons, but you'll get a good audience. There are many people who support you. If they like your cartoons, they'll share it on social media on different platforms. And maybe if you're really good enough, clients will find you. Try to make better use of social media platforms. My journey, I mean, if I want to go back to my journey, it was similar to many cartoonists' journey. I'm not a trained cartoonist. I'm a self-taught cartoonist. I never thought I'll become a professional cartoonist. But somehow I managed to preserve that passion and persist with it. It was a long and tough journey, but I became a professional cartoonist somehow. Of course, I'm not repenting.
Don't you fear when you directly attack?
Thanks, Pandan, for your kind words. I try my best to be creative in every cartoon. Sometimes I succeed, sometimes I don't succeed. It happens with any creative field.
Hey, Satish, Philip here.
So there is a question from Vaibhav about conceptualizing a political cartoon. Mostly political cartoons depend on the news breaks. But you have to keep in mind the past incidents, the history of different politicians, different parties, and different issues also. So then it becomes easier for you to conceptualize a cartoon. Like ideation. It's more like telling a story. Sometimes it's more like telling a story. So you have to be good at creating a story and tell through a simplified concept. Don't try to make it a complex issue. So reader should be able to understand easily, because they are not most of the readers are not that patient. They don't spend enough time with the cartoon. So if it's complex, if it demands lots of time, they don't stay with the cartoon. So it has to be simple, yet creative. Maybe try to be different in every cartoon. There's a question from Rahul. Don't you fear when you raise issues, you will not be liked by power centers? See, every cartoon will offend somebody. And most of the editorial cartoons are on politics. So it will offend not just leaders, mostly it will offend the followers of a certain party. So they, because of the IT cells and all, it's difficult because they start trolling you, they start threatening you, they start abusing you. It's become a part and parcel of any political cartoons. So I'm trying to accept it, though it's difficult. But it's a job I've been doing the same job during UPA rule. I'll be continuing the same job even after 2024 or later. So it's the same job. It's just a job for me. Who occupies the power? It doesn't matter. So there's a question from Deepak Naik. Sir, initially when you began your career as a cartoonist, were you doing freehand drawing without computer? Yes, when I started drawing cartoonist as a freelancer, as a hobby, I used to draw on paper and color it. Mostly those cartoons were published black and white. Later, I used to scan them onto a computer and color it in Photoshop using mouse. So for the last 4-5 years, I've been using the Wacom Cintiq. It saves lots of my time and it gives me lots of options also. But there is a question from Zenith. Are you really drawing now and answering our questions at the same time? No, this is edited video. I'm not drawing actually. These are the cartoons which are created during the Olympics, Tokyo Olympics. So I thought I'll compile all those cartoons together. These are shortened videos. They're not in real time. Of course, while drawing, you can't talk much because you have to focus on the canvas. So there's a question from Philip Prabhakar. Thanks for voicing most of our concerns through your creative pattern. How do you choose any topic? What's your unbiased judgment? Okay. I don't make a choice about the topic mostly because I normally work on the talking point of the day, the topics which are discussed mostly in the media, both mainstream media and on social media, because you can't depend on the mainstream media because they can choose any topic and have a panel discussion for hours. But I normally look at the social media, what people are discussing, and I pick a topic, then work on it. About the unbiased judgment, it's a little tricky because what I feel is unbiased could be a bias for somebody who is being offended. So it's a tricky topic. As people say, every opinion is biased. So my bias is towards the Constitution of India, the nation. What I feel is right, I draw about it. I'm not giving judgment. I'm just sharing my opinion through a cartoon. I may be wrong, I may be right, but this is my opinion. Philip Prabhakar says, great, thanks for your answers, but I see always you are on right side. Thanks for standing. I don't know whether I'm on right side or left side, because right wing people say I'm on the right side. I'm not on the right side. I'm on the left side. Mostly people look at cartoons through their bias. So that's why they find many cartoons biased. Any more questions? So drawing these cartoons to pay tribute to our Olympic champions. It's a kind of a break for me. I mean, most of the political issues are so toxic. I mean, because of social media, that you sometimes you fed up drawing cartoons on politics. So sports is a good break. So I really enjoyed drawing these cartoons. So Deepak Naik asks about R.K. Lakshman and the other legends. Whether they were using technology. I don't think they were using any technology. They were purely classical cartoonists. They used to draw on paper and they used to color it on paper with the traditional, in a traditional way. They were greats. So now that we have technology and it eases our life, most of the cartoonists, most of the artists use the technology very wisely. But I still continue to draw on paper whenever there is an opportunity. So there's a question from Zenith. Do people attack you on social media for drawing cartoons against a party or heroes? I'm not sure. I mean, people get offended. Sometimes what happens is IT cell trolls attack you because of a direction, some order given by the top people. Maybe sometimes they don't understand why they are attacking. They just attack some people, some journalists, some satirists. Whenever they feel that some cartoons offend them, their leader basically, not the party. Sometimes they tolerate the cartoons on their party, but they don't tolerate cartoons on their hero or heroes. That's tragedy. So Philip Prabhakar asked me, what are your other hobbies? I love watching movies and I love listening to music. I love cricket. I religiously follow cricket. These are other hobbies. Sometimes I get to read something. What do you like more, paper or digital? Rahul is asking. I like both. Digital is more convenient, so I use it more frequently. Paper I use whenever I need to practice sketching. Improve my sketching, caricaturing skills, I use paper. So Ravi Suman is asking, sometimes I feel very demotivated when I don't get appreciations. So there's the addiction to social media because you start drawing for likes and comments or shares, that's a tragedy. You should avoid it. You should focus on the quality of your cartoons to make the next cartoon better. Then automatically you will get appreciation, but you should not depend on it. You should not get addicted to it. And appreciation on social media depends on many things, not just the quality of your cartoons. Sometimes there's a way Facebook, Twitter shares your works to your followers. It can restrict the access to your cartoons also. So you should not depend too much on this feedback. Thanks, Aniket, for joining. So any more questions? I'm here to take your questions.
I have posted in the chat window, please.
Swayam Siddha is asking the same question about the device I use. Now I use a Wacom Cintiq. It's a 13 HD. It's more like computer, drawing on a computer. I don't use paper now. I don't have to draw on paper and scan it on the computer. I can draw directly on a software. It saves time. It gives lots of options. You can use any device which can give you some good result. You can use iPad also. You can use paper and pen also. That's the most convenient if you can scan it on the computer and color it in digital software, software like Photoshop or something else. Or you can draw in a traditional way also. You can color it in traditional way. These devices, they don't make your drawing easy. You have to have certain skills to draw. Only then you can draw better. The drawing skill is important, even on paper or on any device. There is a misconception that apps or software can make your drawing better. It might help you make your drawing look better by coloring or some effects. But the basic drawing skills, they won't help you to improve your drawing skills. Maybe you have to use the paper and pencil to improve your drawing skills. And more than the drawing skill, the cartooning, editorial cartooning is more about ideas. So no software can help you to come up with better ideas. So it depends on you only. For a beginner, the focus should be on the drawing skills. Maybe gradually you can start reading and start to form your own opinion about what's happening around you. It's a continuous process. I mean, you keep improving as you read more, as you follow many perspectives of the news. It's a long journey. You keep improving as you go along the cartooning profession. You can improve your drawing skills by sketching. Maybe sketch from life around you, maybe from the videos and photos. You can even copy the cartoons of some good cartoonists. Gradually, you'll develop your own style. Because a drawing style is very important. Because readers, they don't look at your signature. They look at your cartoon style and they'll realize, they'll identify you. Tanu Shetty is asking about the software. I use Krita. I also use Photoshop. I mostly use Krita now. Ravi Suman is asking for a course on YouTube. I need to start a course on YouTube or Discord. I need to plan it. It will take some time. Javed Sheikh is asking about the drawing tablet. Which one is good? See, I used only Wacom Cintiq, so I know about Wacom Cintiq. It's been helpful for me, and I'm very comfortable with Wacom Cintiq. I've heard from other artists that even iPad is good. iPad and using the Procreate software is also good. So you can experiment with these different tablets. So Deepak Nayak is asking a tough question. Are there any legal implications for political cartoons? Because nowadays expressing our opinion has become very dangerous, even in the WhatsApp groups. Or is there any immunity for the journalist? See, as a journalist, I have the right to question the government, and even as a citizen, it's my right to question the government. And as a journalist, I send my questions through cartoons, and even otherwise, every voter, every citizen of this country should have the right to question the government, because they have elected the ruler. They are answerable. Our rulers are answerable. So Constitution gives us that right to question the government. We're just doing that. Thank you, Shubham Mishra, for your kind words. Thanks for joining. Javed Sheikh is asking, can you suggest any book to start with? I don't know about any books, but you can find lots of tutorials on YouTube. So search for cartoon, editorial cartoon tutorial or basic drawing tutorials. You get many options. Maybe you can pick a tutorial or a drawing lesson which suits your style or ability. Persistence is very important because you won't become a good artist in a day. You need to work on it. You need to sketch regularly in a more disciplined way. You need to explore. Only then you can become a better artist. And to become a better editorial cartoonist, you need to track news religiously. You need to read newspapers, you need to read books, and you need to listen to different perspectives also. Follow journalists, activists, and some other celebrities who make sense, who tweet sense. You'll get to learn a lot about different aspects of news. Different perspectives of the news. Any more questions? So last two cartoons are pending. It will take some 15 minutes, I guess. 10, 15 minutes. So you have 10 minutes to ask any questions. Shubham Mishra says at least somewhere the tribute is going towards the real heroes, not to any politicians. That's why I really enjoyed paying tribute to these heroes. I mean, I'm at fault also because I mostly draw on cricketers apart from politicians. So we remember these heroes only during Olympics. So I really enjoyed paying tribute to them. And in fact, some of them responded to the tweets also. Tweets of these cartoons, really kind of them. You can't expect Indian cricketers to respond to a cartoon. Normally they don't ignore, or they just ignore these cartoons. I think we need to draw more cartoons on these heroes. Even when the Olympics is not happening, that's the only way we can pay an ideal tribute to these sports persons. There is a question which I missed on the chat. What's the plan to gear up next generation youth to train them for the great work you do? Having to stand for an issue just like you do. See, you can't train cartoonists. I mean, they have to get inspired by cartoons, and they should be passionate about it because see, cartooning as a profession, it can't compete with the other professional choices. Like maybe medical or engineering or some other choices, which are better paying. Cartooning is still unpredictable. Your future is unpredictable. Once you establish yourself, maybe you'll get a better opportunities and you'll get a better pay also. Till then, only passion will drive you to continue in this profession. I try my best to guide young cartoonists who try to get some tip from me. I try to guide them, correct their drawing or guide them in a right way. Of course, to draw in a right way, like with a spine, it has to come from within. You can't teach it to anybody. I mean, even to journalists, I mean, it has to be inside them. They have to have the courage to question the government. They should be brave enough. They should have the conviction also. Only then they can become a better journalist or a cartoonist. So this is the last cartoon in the compilation. So it will take some 6-7 minutes, I guess. I will surely try to have more sessions. It's been hectic, so it's a little difficult. So if you have questions, there is only 5 minutes left, 5 to 6 minutes. Thanks, Shubham. Thanks so much for joining the interaction session. It was at a very short notice. I really value your time. Thank you so much. See you next time soon. Please take care. Bye-bye.